Well, the big red monkey with the funky hand is back, and this time he's played by the sheriff from Stranger Things. Yeah, that guy. Guy couldn't handle a bunch of vines, now he's playing a demon who fights for America. As funny as it might sound, he actually did a good job. Honestly, the whole cast did a great job. Ian McShane, a.k.a. Tai Lung from Kung Fu Panda, and some character from Deadwood, among other various characters over the years, plays Professor Broom, and honestly, I felt their interaction was like an overzealous super cop versus his commissioner boss, with just a tiny bit of familial affection. The rest of the cast did good. The other heroes, a psychic girl and a Asian guy, I don't want to spoil it, they did a good job playing off Big Red's Big Red's 40-year-old teenager attitude. And while I do wish the firebug was there, honestly, Psychic Girl was pretty decent as a potential love interest. Let's see. Oh, of course, there is the villain, played by Mila Jovovich, who could have maybe been a little more over the top. She kind of played it a little too subdued, in my humble opinion. But then again, I don't know if she could have played it any other way, based on the character's nature. Although I will say, she plays severed body parts very well. I'm not going to get into that because of spoilers, but let's just say she plays severed body parts really well. The rest of the cast, both heroes and villains, did a fine job. The good guys were fallible, and the bad guys were somewhat sympathetic. The effects were mostly practical. Big Red himself was totally practical, with the exception of one scene. I'm not going to spoil it. Various other non-human characters were done practically, and the CG was only used in times when it was absolutely necessary, although I think one scene in particular could have been done with practical forced perspective, and would have worked better, in my humble opinion. But overall, the creature effects were believable and entertaining to watch. It was fun seeing something and thinking, is this CGI or is it practical? I can't tell. Now, for the fact that this film is rated R, they take full advantage of that. They're dropping profanity, they're throwing gore and blood and guts everywhere. Plenty of it practical, some of it CG, but considering what it was, it had to be practical, or not practical, CG, because that level of practicality would have been too expensive. But they did what they could, and it was gloriously brutal. I mean, if you're a gore hound, this is a good movie for you, because they mix CG and practical gore and blood effects very nicely, to it, so to speak. As for the story, let's just say it might be a bit impenetrable for hardcore fans of the Big Red Monkey, because this to me felt like a grab bag of characters and lore straight out of the comic book. And while it might have been a little truer to the comic book, fans might enjoy it more than non-fans. I will say that. But for some, it might be a bit confusing. Although, I guess if you pay attention, it's not that confusing. Although it will hopefully make some of us, or some of the people who don't know much of the lore, want to look it up and maybe get into the comic books. So this film might steer people towards the comic book, which I'm calling a win. The music was a bit of grunge and a bit of epicness, but I kind of missed the classic film's HB theme. You know, do-do-do-do-do. I can't really hum, so look up Hellboy theme song. It's very good, and while it might not be in this film, it was only missed a little bit. Overall, I'd say the Hellboy remake was good, not great, maybe a small step below the original films, even though this might stay a bit truer to the original source material. And the world it's set up... I don't talk as much as I should, so my throat gets all closed up. Anywho, the lore and world-building this film set up makes me want to see more of it. I want to see a sequel. I really hope the film gets enough good PR to merit a sequel. Hopefully, we'll get a sequel. Sequel, please! If anyone's listening who has clout... This is Mr. J, signing out and reminding you, Ron Perlman may have been the original, but sometimes you gotta call in the sheriff.